All right.
Okay. I'm Teresa Wriston. I'm a geoarchaeologist and associate research professor at Desert Research Institute.
Okay.
And this is my husband, John.
Yeah, my name is John Etchemendy.
So I had just gotten a dog, Zoe, and the dogs were playing and getting along, and we started talking and chatting. And he actually came to AMARCS at DRI, the lecture series. I was giving a presentation on my work in Zimbabwe, and he came that night and was actually talking to one of the Basque fellows that regularly came to AMARCS.
We had this connection because my family are all Basque sheep herders, and she grew up as a sheep herder herself. And so, you know, like our conversations initially and our first dates when we, you know, were sort of exploring together and talking about all these things we had in common, travel and adventure, and yeah, it just clicked. My Atachi, my grandfather, immigrated and was running sheep just south of Sacramento and up towards the Nevada border. His brother, who was here at the time, was herding sheep in the Gardnerville area, Markleyville area. And so he sort of made that trek. We actually have audio cassettes of him when he was 100.
When I was down there, my brother came over, horseback from Markleyville, told me, "You better come to Nevada. Yeah, I'm tired of hearing sheep here, yeah, too lonesome. Yeah, I couldn't stand it anymore." So in the fall, before I go down below, I ask a boss and I come down to Gardnerville. And I was over there in the camp one night.
Where?
Blue Lake, nothing to eat hardly, so I killed a lamb. And, I had put it hanging up a tree, one limb in the tree, not too high. Dog comes barking, and I look outside, out of the tent, and moonlight, and I see the bear was eating my lamb. I took a hatchet and knocked the bear down and killed him.
When they were in the field, when they were out driving their sheep, you know, on these recordings, on these tapes, my Atachi talks about how lonely he was. Getting to the Arborglyphs, though, they were artistic and they were just sort of creative outlets. They marked the trail in some ways, but they, you know, so they had a form and a function. The function was, you know, the other Basque sheep herders would know who was there. You would sort of know, mark sort of areas that you'd been to, but there was an artistic, I mean, you go through there, a lot of paintings or a lot of arborglyphs of women.
Not shocking.
yeah, and you know, these guys were out there and alone. I don't know, it's fascinating to me.
You'll see when you start processing. Yeah.
This should be okay.
Yeah, especially if in.
As an archaeologist, you know, we want to record as much of this cultural material, is what we call it, anything that's physical, that we can. And I think that arborglyphs or dendroglyphs or tree carvings are really emblematic of all the features and artifacts that disappear, you know. The trees only live about 120 years, 150 maybe occasionally. And so these are disappearing now. Like, we need all hands on deck recording these. And there's a lot of other stuff that we don't know about, right, that has already gone. So I think that there's something that everybody can sort of wrap their head around.
Yeah, let's do the point shoot.
Yeah,
let's do that. And then I'll do the DSLR.
Okay.
Before, it looks like the light's fine now, like without the tent.
I know.
Not for
but
long,
it's up.
Though.
It's
I see
up.
It.
And yeah, it's up.
Yeah. Okay.
Better.
And actually, the Arborglyphs, as far as the photogrammetry goes, the reason I got into that was because the drone photography and the artifact, 3D preservation of artifacts. And so it was sort of a natural extension, already having this technical ability to preserve things in a 3D way. The tree carvings are actually perfect for it. And that way we can preserve them. And, you know, we could make models if we wanted to, once they're dead. Feel a strong connection to this project, in part because even though I'm not Basque, I know the way of life. I was raised around many Basques, and my friends were Basques, and people who guided us and taught us about sheep were Basques. And but also I think it's just a very Western story. You know, like we were drawn to the sheep for economic reasons, but it's also a way of life. And I think that's sort of dying, you know.
Ikusinuen igandeño goiz batez bai eta ere agradatu haren begi ederrez luda bat badu baduenez parerik ez ditasunez ene bihotza tristeri dago harekin egon beharrez.